भगवान धर्म प्रभु राजा रानी खाइरे
वहाँ खाई बिजी
दे आर लिटिल बिजी टुडे
ओके ओके ओम ज्ञान तमरंदस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकाया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनिति नाम्ने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चाच्च देशतारिणे वंचकौपातरभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितनां पवानेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे So we're recounting the prayers offered by Prahlad Maharaj to Lord Nrisingadev after Lord Nrisingadev had killed Hiranyakashipu.
आज हामी चाहिँ प्रहलाद महाराजको प्रार्थनाहरू जब चाहिँ हिरण्यकश्यपुलाई नरसिंहदेवले मार्नुहुन्छ त्यसपछि प्रहलाद महाराजले गर्नुभएको स्तुतिहरूको बारेमा चर्चा गर्दैछ
So we heard how Prahlad Maharaj was describing his difficulty in dealing with the senses, how the senses are, all the senses are very active and demand a lot of attention. He said it's just like having five wives. And each wife wants attention and wants to go a different place. However, Prahlad Maharaj says to Lord Nrisingadev, he says, You are always transcendentally situated. You are not disturbed by the demands of the senses. But Prahlad Maharaj said, because of our activities based on the senses and the demands of the body, we are suffering the reactions. And Prahlad Maharaj talks, he said, Lord Nrisingadev, he said, you're on the other side of the river of death. He said, we're on this side where there's birth and death, but you're on the other side of the river where there's no birth and death.
कि हामी यो जन्म मृत्यु जरा व्याधिको यो चक्रमा हामी फसेका छौँ र हामी नदीको यतातिर छौँ तर तपाईँ चाहिँ नदीको अर्कोतिर हुनुहुन्छ अर्को तिरमा जहाँ चाहिँ जन्म मृत्यु जरा व्याधिले तपाईँलाई छुँदैन
There's a river between the material world and the spiritual world. It's called the Vaitaranya River.
र यो भौतिक जगत र आध्यात्मिक जगतको बिचमा एउटा नदी छ त्यो नदीको नाम चाहिँ What is the name of the river, Maharaj?
The Vaitarani.
Vaitarani. Nadi ko naam chai Vaitarani.
So on one side is the spiritual world where there's no birth and death. But on the other side is the material world, which is a world of birth and death.
Yoda tarfa chai bhautik jagat cha, jahan chai janma mrityu jara vyadhi yo dukha haru cha. Tara arko nadi ko arko kinar ma chai
And Prahlad Maharaj said, we're suffering on this side. We're suffering. They have to go through all the pains of the birth and death.
Prahlad Maharaj, तर हामीले चाहिँ यहाँ जन्म मृत्यु जरा व्याधिहरू हामीले चाहिँ यसलाई भोग्न पर्छ तर उता अर्को नदीको अर्को पारमा चाहिँ त्यस्तो केही पनि हुँदैन.
And Prahlad Maharaj said, it's our fault, it's our own activities, we're responsible for our suffering because of our own activities. And some of the foolish things which we do is we eat all kinds of horrible food.
र एउटा मुख्य कारण किन हो त हामीले यसरी दुःख पाइरहेका त भन्दाखेरि हामी नचाहिने कुराहरू खाना खान्छौँ.
People are so ignorant, they don't care what they put into the mouth. They put all kinds of disgusting, contaminated animal flesh into their bodies.
हामी तमोगुणमा छौँ र तमोगुणमा हुँदाखेरि चाहिँ के मुखमा हाल्छौँ हामीलाई थाहा छैन. फोहोर फालेको जस्तै गरेर मुखमा थरी थरीका कुराहरू मरेको जनावरहरूलाई हाल्छौँ नाना थरीका तमोगुणका कुराहरू हामीले खान्छौँ.
They have a saying in Chinese that disease comes from the mouth. The things you put in the mouth is the cause of all the disease.
र चाइनिज भाषामा एउटा भनाइ छ, त्यो भनाइ चाहिँ के हो त भन्दाखेरि मुखमा हामीले के हाल्छौँ रोग चाहिँ मुखबाट आउँछ भनेर भन्ने भनिन्छ.
And people are not very intelligent. They will eat such terrible things, such horrible things, and they think, oh, it tastes very nice. We see people, they like to eat things like fish. The different fish come from the sea, but the fish are in the sea, the fish are eating all kinds of terrible things in the fish body. So many things are put into the sea is so contaminated, the fish are eating, and the people come along and they eat the fish.
तर हामीले देख्न सक्छौँ समुद्रमा कति मान्छेहरूले फोहोर फाल्छन् के सबै ढलसल सबै त्यहीँ लगाएर मिसाउँछन् अनि त्यो सबै माछा नै खाउँछ अनि त्यही कुरालाई हामी खान्छौँ अनि हामीलाई अब कति राम्रो जस्तो लाग्छ.
They will eat also things like even the sacred cow, who is our mother, the most valuable of animals, because she provides milk, which is so important for the health of the body. But people will eat the cow flesh.
तर मान्छेहरू यस्तो मूर्ख पनि छन् कि गाई माता जस्तो हुनुहुन्छ किनभने उहाँले हामीलाई दुध दिनुहुन्छ आमाको दुध बराबर छ र त्यस्तो आमा पूजनीय आमाको पनि मासु खान मान्छेले छोड्दैन.
This planet belongs to the cow, Mother Bhumi. She's the deity in charge of this planet and she has the form of a cow. So this planet actually belongs to the cows and we're meant to take care of the cows.
र भूमि माताको रूप अथवा स्वरूप चाहिँ गाईको जस्तो पनि छ त्यही भएर यो खास पृथ्वी लोक चाहिँ गाई माताकै हो तर त्यस्तो आमा जसले हामीलाई सबै कुरा दिनुभएको छ त्यसकै मासु हामी खान्छौँ.
The cows are domestic creatures. They need to be taken care of. And we need the cows because they give something, the food, which is so important in the form of milk.
र गाई चाहिँ जङ्गली जनावर होइन गाईलाई चाहिँ यसरी घरहरूमा यसरी कृषकहरूले राख्ने मान्छेहरूले राख्नुपर्ने हो र यसरी गाई राख्नाले के हुन्छ त हामीलाई पनि एकदम अनमोल एकदम अमूल्य चिज हामीलाई मिल्छ जस्तै दुध जसले खाएर हामी आध्यात्मिक जीवनमा अगाडि बढ्न सकिन्छ.
And from milk then you can make butter and ghee and cheese and so many nice foodstuffs.
र दुध खानाले नै दुधबाट हामीलाई दुधबाट अरू अरू चिज पनि हामीले परिकार बनाउन सकिन्छ जस्तै दुधबाट दही बनाउन सकिन्छ मक्खन बनाउन सकिन्छ चिज बनाउन सकिन्छ थरी थरीका यस्ता परिकारका चिजहरू बनाउन सकिन्छ.
But in Kali Yuga, in this age, people are so fallen and so ignorant, they don't know milk comes from the cow. They think milk is something which they make in the factory, something like Coca-Cola.
तर कलियुगका मूर्ख व्यक्तिहरूलाई थाहा छैन दुध कहाँबाट आउँछ उनीहरूले सोच्छन् दुध कहाँबाट आयो भने ए फ्याक्ट्रीमा आउँछ कोका कोला बनाए जस्तै भन्छन्.
They think milk is something, maybe it's like, you know, like they make alcohol or wine, so they think milk also comes from something like that. So they kill the cow, they eat the cow flesh, it's the most sinful thing. Because they kill the cow, they will have to be killed. For every hair on the body of the cow, they will have to take birth and be killed. So Prahlad Maharaj says to Lord Nrisingadev, said, we're suffering all of these the reactions because of this. It's causing us to take birth again and again. So Prahlad Maharaj prays to Lord Nrisingadev. He said, please cast your glance upon us, look upon us, not only me, but all the others also who are suffering. And then by your mercy, we can be delivered. So there are two kinds. Prahlad Maharaj is praying not just for himself but for others. So there are two kinds of devotees. One devotee, he thinks only about his own self, and the other devotee, he thinks about others. So there's a Bhajanandi. He's only thinking about his own self. He does his own chanting, he does his bhajan, he worships the Lord, but only for his own benefit. He doesn't think about others. But the Gostavanandi is somebody who will think of, tries to deliver others, he tries to bring other people to Krishna consciousness. So we see people are, you know, generally people, materialistic people, they don't know about the next life. They don't think about what happens at the time of death. They don't understand that the activities they're doing in this life will determine the kind of body they take in the next life. So there's people who never surrender to Krishna. They're described in the Bhagavad Gita to be foolish people like donkeys called mudhas. They do a lot of sinful activities, they eat all kinds of food, of horrible things. In the next life, they get a horrible body. So if they eat like a pig, the next life they can get a pig body. So a devotee, he's worried about this, he's very careful to avoid any sinful activity. and he will always try to engage in Krishna conscious activities. So Krishna comes in this world to try to help people, to instruct them, to save them from the miseries of material life. And Lord Chaitanya ordered everyone that they should become Krishna conscious, they should study the books about Krishna. Even if they just simply read the Bhagavad Gita, they can become a spiritual master and they can deliver the souls, they can save souls from a hellish birth. Shankaracharya said, a little drop of Ganges water in the Bhagavad Gita can liberate one from birth and death. And Lord Chaitanya told the Brahmana at Kurmadesh, Yari Deki Tarikaho Krishna Upadesh. Wherever you go, whoever you meet, tell people about Krishna, the instructions of Krishna. Lord Chaitanya said, Amara Gai Guru Hanak Tarae Desh. Lord Chaitanya told everyone, you should become a spiritual master, you should save the world. The Brahmana at Kurmadesh, he was thinking to leave home and go with Lord Chaitanya, but Lord Chaitanya told him, no, you just stay here, you don't need to leave home. You just stay where you are and preach, tell everyone about Krishna. So we see devotees all over the world, they're following these instructions. They have programs in their home, they have bhakti briksha programs, and they invite people to come and they teach them about Krishna. Krishna consciousness is in everybody's heart. People are just waiting to hear about Krishna. Now, this month of December, the devotees all around the world are working very hard to try to distribute more books. Because many people, they come to Krishna consciousness, their first contact with Krishna consciousness was through one of the books. They got a book and they read about Krishna and they were interested. So wherever you are, if you have some books, you just need to go out and try and distribute them.
Now,
It doesn't matter if you're in Machina or Rangoon or what's the other city?
Mandalay.
Mandalay, yeah, Mandalay, right. It doesn't matter where you are. But the important thing is you try to give Krishna to others. And a devotee, we don't need to consider who's qualified and who's not, but Krishna's in the heart of everyone. We may say, oh no, this person, he's not qualified, no, that person. We discriminate on the basis of the body. We use our material judgment to consider who's qualified and who's not. But this is wrong. We have to see everybody as a spirit soul. Everyone is a potential devotee of Krishna. Krishna consciousness is not sectarian, it's for everyone, it's for everyone. Doesn't matter if they're Nepali or Hindu or Buddhist or Christian or whatever, white or black, it doesn't matter.
Krishna Bhavanamit, kunai euta samaj ko vyakti haru lai, kunai euta desh ko vyakti lai, kunai dharma ko vyakti lai matrai hoina, yo chai sabai vyakti haru lai. Buddhist life, when you know, such a Christian life, Hindu life, Bacha life, Buddha life, Sapai life,
and the birth is not important. The birth is not the qualification to become a devotee. In the times of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, he had to fight against people called the Nityananda Vamshas. They were claiming that they had the birthright to be the acharyas and to initiate people in Krishna consciousness.
Nityananda Vamsa.
So Lord Nityananda, you know, he married and he had two wives, just as Balaram had two wives. These two ladies who were Balaram's wife, they came again and they were the wives of Lord Nityananda, Janava and Vasuti. Vashuni, huh? Two sisters, and they were both married to Lord Nityananda. And Lord Nityananda had one child by Vasuti. Janava didn't have any offspring, but Vasuti, she had a child, and that child was Virabhadra.
The name of the son, Maharaj?
Virabhadra.
Virabhadra.
I had a daughter also, Ganga Devi. So Virabhadra, he never married. He was a brahmachari, so he had no descendant. But the people who were all in the same village where Lord Nityananda was living with Virabhadra and where they all lived, the people there, they were all claiming that they're the descendants of Lord Nityananda. They called themselves the Nityananda Vamshas. So they claimed they had the birthright to be the Acharya.
So
Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati had to preach against them. He had to say, you can preach if you like. Yeah, you can also be guru, you can teach. But everybody else has also got a right too, not only you. Guru is not established on the basis of birth. It's not a birthright. You have to have the qualification, you have to do the work, have the qualities, and do the teaching and the mission of the spiritual teacher.
Guru chahi koi byakti janma bada hamile tetti gai kasailai guru banauna millain usma tyo gun hunu parcha ra usle pani yo prachar garna paryo ra chaitanya mahaprabhu le bhanyo ancha yesari thau thau ma gaera prachar garyo bhane usle hamile guru manna sakincha.
So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati had to fight against these people to establish that Krishna consciousness is for everyone.
Ra tei bhara Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati le
And based on the instruction of Lord Chaitanya, anybody can become a guru. Anybody who knows the science of Krishna, Lord Chaitanya told, Ramananda Rai told Lord Chaitanya, kiba vipra kiba nasi sudra keni nai ye Krishna tadvavet se guru hoy. That it does not matter if you're a vipra, a brahmana, or a sannyasi, or a sudra, that birth is not important. But if you know the science of Krishna, then you can become a spiritual teacher.
Ramananda Rai le Chaitanya Mahaprabhu le bhanne hununcha ki kiba vipra kiba nyasi.
So Prahlad Maharaj is praying to Lord Nrisingadev. He said, you're the original spiritual master of the world. And you manage all the affairs of the universe. So if you can do all of these things, you can also deliver all the fallen souls and you can bring them all to devotional service. Yeah, Lord Prahlad Maharaj said, you're the friend of the people who are suffering in the world. So Prahlad said, I think you can give your mercy to people like us who are engaged in your service. So we see in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Samoham sarva bhuteshu name dveshosti na priya, ye bhajanti tu mam bhakta mai te teshu chapyaham. Krishna said, I am equal to everyone. I envy no one. I am equal to everyone. But whoever renders service to me, he is a friend, he is in me, and I am in him.
Bhagavad Gita ki yo shlok ma bhagwan le bhannu huncha कि समूहम सर्वभूतेषु म सबै जीवहरूप्रति सम दृष्टिकोणले हेर्दछु तर जसले मलाई भजन गर्छ जसले मलाई पूजा गर्छ सेवा गर्दछ तिनीहरू चाहिँ म भित्रै छन् र उनीहरू भित्र पनि म छु भन्नुहुन्छ भगवान्।
So Krishna sees everybody equally, but he has a special love for his devotees.
र भगवान कृष्णले सबै जीवहरूलाई समान रूपले हेर्नुहुन्छ किनभने सबै जीवहरू भगवानकै अंश हुन् तर जसले चाहिँ भगवानको भजन गर्छ सेवा गर्दछ उनीहरूलाई विशेष भगवानले प्रेम गर्नुहुन्छ।
Just like a mother, she loves all children, but she has a special love for her own children.
जस्तै एउटा आमाले सबै सबै बच्चाहरूलाई समान रूपले हेर्नुहुन्छ तर आफ्नो बच्चाहरूलाई उहाँले विशेष प्रेम गर्नुहुन्छ।
So the same way Krishna has a special affection for those who are engaged in his service and he takes special care for them.
Ra jasari testai garera bhagwan krishna le pani testa bhakta haru jasle chai aphno nirantar rup le bhagwan ka sewa ma laeka cha testa bhakta haru prati bhagwan ko vishesh prem huncha prem huncha.
So we should understand that it's very important for us also to become the servant of Krishna's devotees. That if we will serve Krishna's devotees, it's even better than serving Krishna directly.
र भगवानको भक्तहरूको सेवा गर्नु पनि यो एकदम महत्त्वपूर्ण छ खास भगवानलाई सिधै सेवा गर्न भन्दा भगवानको भक्तहरूलाई सेवा गर्न झन् राम्रो।
So Lord Chaitanya, he taught us to be the servant of the servant of the servant of the gopis.
र चैतन्य महाप्रभुले हामीलाई सिकाउनु भएको छ कि गोपीहरूको सेवकको सेवकको सेवक हामी बन्नुपर्छ।
We should not think we can go directly to Krishna. We have to go through the devotees.
Just
like in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna speaks about the disciplic succession. He says, Evam parampara praptam imam raja sheo vidu sakaliniha mahata yoga nashta parantapa. This knowledge is passed through the line of disciplic succession, and the saintly kings understood it in that way.
Just like Bhagavad Gita, Evam parampara praptam. You gyan, adhyatmik gyan, they kosari ayagasana vanda, parampara vada, guru haru vada, guru haru vada, madhyam vada, amile Bhagavan Krishna ko siksha pauna sakincha.
We cannot understand Krishna directly. We have to hear about Krishna from the devotee. If we try to go directly to Krishna, we won't be. Just like if you try to go to see the president of India. If you go say, Mr. Modi, I want to see you. I'm coming from Mayapur. I want to see Mr. Modi. You know, Mr. Modi, you know, he's a busy man. He's not going to see just anybody who comes from a village. But if you know the secretary, if you know Mr. Modi's secretary, he can arrange for you to meet Mr. Modi. So the same way, we want to know Krishna, we know Krishna through the devotees. We have to go through the devotees, not directly.
र त्यस्तै गरेर यदि हामीले भगवान्लाई पनि चिन्न चाहन्छौँ भगवान्लाई भेट्न चाहन्छौँ भने हामीले भगवान्का भक्तहरूद्वारा हामी चाहिँ भगवान्सँग सम्पर्क राख्न सकिन्छ।
Narottam Das Thakur sings, Dandara Charana Seva Bhakta Sanivas, Janame Janame Seya Bilas. He says, let me serve the feet of the devotees. Let me live with the devotees, birth after birth. That's my only desire. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he said, let me be your dog. He said, oh dear devotee, please just consider me like your dog. Hare Krishna.
Yes, Maharaj, I think the connection is little
unstable, eh? Yeah, probably. Yeah. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, Maharaj. Now it's okay. Bhaktivinoda Thakur le bhannuhuncha ki malai ta tapaiko bhaktaharuko gharma kukur bhaye pani thik cha.
So become the dog of a pure devotee. Then their life is successful.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur bhannuhuncha bhakta shuddha bhakta ko yasari ma kukur huna paye bhane pani mero jivan chai sarthak hunecha.
Because Krishna is the property of the pure devotee, so the pure devotee, he can give us Krishna. Krishna se tomar, Krishna dite par. You say, Krishna is yours, you have the power to give him to me. So the devotee prays like that to the devotee. And in the Srimad Bhagavatam also, Lord Krishna tells Uddhava that you have to do service for the devotee. You must take the shelter of a devotee, and then you can please me. Just like there's one temple in South India, it's a Ramanuja temple. So the Sri Vaishnavas, they also have this, they also give this point, the very important point, to serve the devotees. So there was this one temple, and there was a very good devotee there, a very great devotee. He used to be the pujari, and he would speak to the deity, and the deity could have a conversation with him. So one devotee, he said, I know this devotee, he speaks to the deity. So he asked the devotee, he said, can you ask the deity, am I going to get liberation at the end of this life? So the devotee asked the deity, and the deity said, yeah, that devotee, he will get liberated at the end of the life. This is his last birth in the material world. So then the devotee, he thought about himself. So he asked the deity, he said, what about me? He said, well, I also get liberated. Is this also my last birth? So the deity said, no. He said, you only serve me. You don't serve the devotees. If you want to get liberation, you have to serve the devotees.
Mm-hmm. तर त्यो अर्को भक्तले त अरू भक्तहरूलाई पनि सेवा गरेन त्यही भएर उसमा चाहिँ चाँडै मुक्ति हुँदैछ.
So this devotee, he'd been a pujari all the time. He'd been, spent years in the temple worshipping the deity. He'd never served the devotees. So when he heard this from the deity, then he realized he had to do something. So he went, he got out of the temple, and but wherever he went, people, he tried to serve people. They wouldn't let him serve. They said, "No, no, I'm not taking service from you. You're a great devotee. I know about you. You talk to the deity," and he couldn't get to serve anybody. So then he thought what to do. Then he decided, he changed all his cloth, and he put on old cloth, and he didn't wear the saffron cloth, he just put on white cloth, and he looked like an ordinary person, and he went far away from the temple where nobody knew him. And he found there was one little farm, some people were living there, and he saw they were very pious, they were very religious people. So he stayed near the farm, and he would go secretly, and he would wash the cows, and he would clean the cows, and he would take care of the cows. He would do it all secretly without anybody knowing.
वस्त्र लाउनु भएको थियो त्यो निकालेर सेतो पुरानो लुगा लाउनु भयो र कसैले नचिन्ने रूपले उहाँ एउटा गाउँमा गएर त्यहाँ गाउँका राम्रा भक्तहरू रहेछन् भनेर थाहा पाएपछि र उनीहरूको गाईहरूको सेवा गर्नुभयो, गाईहरूलाई धुने, गाईहरूको सेवा गर्ने र उनीहरूले नथाहा पाउने किसिमले यसरी सेवा गर्नु.
So he did this. After some time, then the people started to understand, somebody is taking care of our cows, who's doing it? So then they found out, and they saw, oh, it's this devotee. They said, oh no, we don't like you taking, we don't want to take service from you. Anyway, he did a lot of service for them, and then he went back to the temple. And then the deity said, yes, he said, now you can get liberated. Now you've served the devotees. Now you're qualified. You can go back to Godhead.
So
Prahlad Maharaj, he doesn't want just to get liberation on his own. He wants that all the other souls should also be liberated.
Prahlad Maharaj knows that
So Prahlad Maharaj, he has that desire to see the whole world become Krishna conscious. Just like Lord Chaitanya's time, there was a great devotee called Vasudev Datta. He also prayed to Lord Chaitanya that, let me take the sins of all the sinful people and let them all be delivered, and I will stay here and suffer.
जस्तै वासुदेव दत्त पनि चैतन्य महाप्रभुको लीलामा वासुदेव दत्त भन्ने एकजना भक्त हुनुहुन्थ्यो, उहाँले पनि यस्तै किसिमको प्रार्थना गर्नुभएको थियो कि सबै यी पापी व्यक्तिहरूको चाहिँ पाप मैले लिन्छु र यिनीहरूलाई चाहिँ भगवान् तपाईँले उद्धार गर्नुहोस्, भगवत धाम लिएर जानुहोस्, म चाहिँ यिनीहरूको सबै पाप लिएर यही भौतिक जग्गामा बसिरहन्छु.
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, he was very pleased, and he told Vasudev Datta, he said, you must be Prahlad Maharaj, you must be the incarnation of Prahlad Maharaj, because Prahlad Maharaj, he has that kind of thinking also.
त्यसपछि चैतन्य महाप्रभु एकदम खुसी हुनुभयो उहाँको यस्तो प्रार्थना अरूहरूको भलाइको लागि यस्तो प्रार्थना सुनेर र चैतन्य महाप्रभुले भन्नुभयो कि तिमी चाहिँ प्रह्लाद महाराजै हुनुपर्छ किनभने प्रह्लाद महाराजले पनि पहिला यस्तै प्रार्थना गर्नुभएको थियो
Because of the mercy of Vasudev Datta, Lord Chaitanya arranged to deliver everyone. Everyone was delivered. Of course, the whole world, the whole universe fills up again because there's so many conditioned souls. Delivering one universe, that is just like one mustard seed from a bag of mustard seeds. So we're coming up now with this very wonderful verse here spoken by Prahlad Maharaj, very beautiful verse. Prahlad Maharaj says that I'm not afraid of the material existence because wherever I stay, I can just think of you and chant your glories. He said, I'm only worried about these foolish people who make plans for their material happiness, who've tried to maintain their family and society and country. I'm worried about them.
मलाई त तपाईँको भजन गर्नाले तपाईँको स्मरण गर्नाले म यो भौतिक जगतबाट पर हुन सक्छु मलाई त केही छैन तर यी मूर्ख व्यक्तिहरू जसले चाहिँ आफ्नो परिवार आफ्नो देश मेरो समाज भनेर त्यही यसमै डुबेका छन् आफ्नै शरीर र यसको उसको मात्रै डुबेका छन् उनीहरूको मलाई चिन्ता छ
So people have been making plans, trying to save us from all the miseries of the material world. They've been making plans for hundreds and thousands of years. And still there's miseries. Although they make so many attempts, they're never successful. They cannot change the nature of the material world.
र यसरी फरक फरक क्रियाकलाप गरेर सोचेर थरी थरीका क्रियाकलाप गरे पनि भौतिक जगतमा सधैँ दुःख नै छ फरक फरक नयाँ रोगहरू आइरहेका छन् के भइरहेको छ दुःख चाहिँ दुःख नै छ
No, it's the nature of the material world to give us difficulties. It's Durga, Mother Durga's duty is to punish the sinful people.
र यो यो हाम्रो सोचाइले हाम्रो क्रियाकलापले मात्रै यो भौतिक जगतमा दुःखबाट सुख हुन सक्दैन किनभने यो त दुःखालयम हो दुर्गा माताले हामीहरूलाई दुःख किन दिनुभएको छ त भन्दाखेरि एउटा तरिकाले अर्को तरिकाले दुःख दिइराख्नुहुन्छ किनभने हामी पापी छौँ त्यो चाहिँ हामी भगवान्मा शरण पर्दैनौँ यो चाहिँ मुख्य कुरा
हो एभ्रीबडी इज ट्राइङ टु फाइट अगेन्स्ट द मटेरियल एनर्जी दे आर ट्राइङ टु एन्जॉय बट नोबडी क्यान डिफीट मदर दुर्गा
जीवहरू चाहिँ सबै बद्ध जीवहरूले चाहिँ यसो भएन यसरी गर्न सकिन्छ कि यसोबाट गर्यो भने दुःखको सट्टा सुख पाइन्छ भनेर उनीहरूले थरी थरीका तरिकाहरू निकालिरहेका छन् तर दुर्गा मातालाई हामीहरूले कसैले पनि हराउन सकिँदैन
Mother Durga is very powerful. She has 10 arms and she comes on lying on the, she rides on the lion. The lion is a symbol of the mode of passion.
र दुर्गा माताका दसवटा हातहरू छन् उहाँ सिंहमाथि चढेर आउनुहुन्छ र यो चाहिँ सिंह अथवा उहाँ चाहिँ रजोगुणको पनि सन्देश गर्नुहुन्छ हामीलाई
And she has got all the 10 arms, they're all carrying different weapons which she uses to punish the sinful people.
Mm-hmm.
So people are trying to get over, they're trying to get free of the material energy, but they don't want to surrender to Krishna, so they can never be successful. If people want to get free from the material nature, they have to surrender, they have to get the mercy of Krishna. The material nature is under his control. And Mother Durga is also under Krishna's control. Lord Brahma describes, Srishti Stiti Pralaya Sadhana Saktareka Chayeva Yashya Bhuvanani Vibharti Durga Echan Rupam Api Yashya Chachesta Tesa Govindam Adipursam Tamaham Bhajamin. Lord Brahma is saying the material nature is controlled by Durga and it moves like a shadow under the control of Krishna. So Mother Durga, she is the creating, maintaining and annihilating deity of the mundane world. And she has many, many devotees here. And they are thinking Mother Durga is supreme, but Mother Durga, she is under the control of Lord Sri Krishna. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna said, Mayadyakshena Prakriti Suyate Sacharacharam. This material nature is moving under my direction, O son of Kunti. It's not under Durga's direction, it's under Krishna's direction. So people are suffering in the material world, but Prahlad Maharaj, he's not suffering because he's a devotee, he's in Krishna consciousness. So he doesn't suffer, even though he's in the material world. So if a devotee is in Krishna consciousness, he'll be happy, he's trying to serve Krishna and he'll be experiencing the bliss of spiritual life. But people in material life, they're suffering, they're miserable. Yeah, they're unhappy because they're making plans, they're trying to make plans for their happiness in the material world separate from Krishna. So Prahlad Maharaj says, this is their mistake. They can never be successful. So we will stop if there's any question.
महाराज क्लास आज यही अन्त गर्न चाहनुहुन्छ र कसैको प्रश्न छ भने सोध्न सक्नुहुन्छ
हरे कृष्ण दण्डवत प्रणाम गुरु महाराज
हरे कृष्ण दण्डवत प्रणाम
प्रभुजी अघि महाराजले भन्नुभएको थियो नि जो भगवानको भन्दा भक्तको सेवा गरेको अझै राम्रो भन्ने हरे कृष्ण प्रभु
हजुर सुनिरहेछु प्रभु
भन्नु त्यही त भगवानको सेवा त हामीले अब जस्तो मङ्गल आरती गरिन्छ श्रृङ्गार आरती भोग इत्यादि अनि सन्ध्या आरती त्यसरी गरिन्छ तर भक्तको सेवा चाहिँ कसरी गर्ने त्यो प्रोसेस कस्तो छ
So Maharaj, Nimai Prabhu's question is, in the class that it's even better to serve the devotees than the Supreme Lord directly. And Nimai Prabhu is saying, we serve the Lord, the Mangal Arati, the Singhar Arati, we change the dress, we offer prasadam, we chant for them. That process is given to us, but how do we serve the devotees?
How do we serve the devotees? Well, just like you offer the Lord prasadam, Yeah, you offer food to the Lord, you offer the devotees the Lord's prasadam. That's service to the devotees. You try to discuss Krishna consciousness with them. That is also service to the devotees. If you share, you have some realization about Krishna, you discuss with them about Krishna, that is very nice service. Sometimes we make programs and we invite the devotees to come for the program. We may have a festival or we may have a house program. We invite the devotees, come and join us. We'll have kirtan, we have pravachan, we have prasadam. Sometimes you read the book to the devotee, read a book to them, let them hear Krishna's pastimes or Krishna's qualities from Prabhupada's book. Sometimes you take the devotee to the temple, you bring him to a holy place. Sometimes the devotee may be ill, he may be sick. You can help, you can take care of them. When I got dengue, when I was in Bangkok, I got dengue, devotees were taking care of me. That is service to the devotee. I'm very grateful. Okay.
कसको प्रश्न छ हजुरहरूले मात्रै गर्नु पर्यो अरू आवाज आए जस्तो छ आई एम जस्ट टेलिङ देम टु म्युट
हजुर
भन्नुहोस्
जगन्नाथपुरीमा जब जगन्नाथ मन्दिरमा सेवा गर्ने पण्डालहरू हुनुहुन्छ उहाँहरू पान त खानुहुन्छ पान सुर्ती चबाउनुहुन्छ उहाँहरूले त्यही पनि उहाँहरूले मन्दिर दर्शनको लागि पाश्चात्य देशका विदेशीहरूलाई घुस्न अनुमति दिनु हुँदैन त्यसमा चैतन्य महाप्रभुले त्यसलाई किन रोक्नु भएन अघि महाराजले भन्नुभएको थियो कि जन्म सिद्धिले मात्रै हुँदैन के अरे योग्यता पनि चाहिन्छ भने अब ती पण्डालहरू त चैतन्य महाप्रभुको समयदेखि नै तिनीहरू त अब त्यस्तै परम्परामा चलेर आइरहेछन् ती व्यक्तिहरू पनि
भीम के अरे हजुरको दीक्षाको नाम के अरे प्रभु
बृहत भानु
बृहत भानु प्रभु हेज अ क्वेसन that he is asking that you know in Jagannath Puri the Pandals the priests of the Jagannath Puri they have been smoking bidi and chewing the tobacco and but they are still continuing their services and things like that and but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not stop them he although they are born in that family and they have been doing that for a long time as you had said earlier that it's just the birthright but although they were not so qualified Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not stop them why did he not stop them that's his question
well Ramanujacharya had come there and he planned to stop everything and change everything but that same night before he could change everything Lord Jagannath threw him out took him out of Jagannath Puri and moved him and he woke up in Kurukshetra
रामानुजाचार्य राइट महाराज जस्तै एउटा यो लीला छ जगन्नाथको कि जस्तै रामानुजाचार्य त्यहाँ जगन्नाथपुरीमा आउनु भएको थियो र उहाँले देख्नुभयो कति कुरा चाहिँ त्यहाँ मिलेको छैन र उहाँलाई परिवर्तन गर्न मन लागेको थियो त्यो परिवर्तन उहाँले गर्ने सोचिराख्नु भएको थियो तर राति सुत्दाखेरि जगन्नाथले उहाँलाई कुर्म क्षेत्रमा लगेर राखिदिनु भयो
सो We have to understand the desire of Lord Jagannath is supreme. That Lord Jagannath values the service of these people and he doesn't want to change anything.
So Jagannath le yi bhakta haru ko seva lai apnaunu bhayeko chha ra waha lai tyo pariwartan garna chaina. Waha le tyo seva yi byakti haru ko seva lai waha le apnaunu bhayeko chha. र त्यसलाई हामीले सम्मान गर्नु पर्यो
त्यसो भने बर्थ राइट अब ती व्यक्तिहरू भगवान् जगन्नाथजी त भावग्राही जनता अब उहाँहरूले जस्तो भावले शुद्ध होस् या अशुद्ध होस् जुनसुकै परिस्थितिमा पनि भगवान्ले त स्वीकार गर्नुभयो नि
अब भगवान्ले गर्नुभयो सो प्रभुज क्वेसन इज अगेन फर्दर क्वेसन इज हि सेइङ सो जगन्नाथ एक्सेप्टेड देयर बर्थ
Yes.
Even if they were not qualified, are not qualified, he accepted their service, right?
Yeah, he accepts their service, right?
जगन्नाथले चाहिँ त्यो अपनाउनु भयो भने जगन्नाथले त्यो सेवा उनीहरूको गुण नभए पनि उनीहरूलाई अपनाउनु भयो
Just look at the service they do. Look how many offerings they make every day. And look at the festival they put on every year. They build a big chariot, a big, huge chariot. Every year they build a new chariot and they do it every year. Even this year when they had lockdown, still they did Rath Yatra. So they're very devotee.
हामीले उनीहरूले गरेको सेवालाई पनि हेर्न पर्यो उनीहरूले हरेक दिन कतिवटा यसरी खाना बनाएर चढाउँछन् भगवान्लाई त्यस्तै गरेर साथसाथै त्यत्रो ठुलो ठुलो रथ बनाउँछन् हरेक साल नयाँ नयाँ रथ बनाउँछन् र यो वर्ष कोरोना लाग्दाखेरि पनि उनीहरूले रथ बनाएर यसरी रथयात्रा गरे भन्यो
त्यही भएर उनीहरूले गरेको सेवालाई पनि हामीले त्यसो भने त विधि भन्दा पनि सेवा ठुलो भयो नि
होला अब त्यस्तै मान्नु परेको होइन अब भगवान्ले अपनाउनु भयो भने अब के भन्नुहुन्छ त If the Lord accepts, then what can we say, right, Mother?
Right, that's right.
He is the ultimate controller.
अच्छा प्रभु श्री कृष्ण म एउटा सुन्नु पत्र छ भन्नुहोला भगवान श्री कृष्णले दशम स्कन्दमा मातालाई भन्नुभएको छ तिमीले मेरो काम गर योग माया वा यो गर अनि भरे गर तिमीलाई सबैले पूजा गर्नेछन् भन्नुभएको छ र हामीले दुर्गा माताको पूजा गरेर छोडियो अथवा गरिएन भने भगवानको अपमान हुन्छ कि हुन्न? त्यो महाराजले सोध्यो।
त्यो के दशौँ स्कन्दमा के भन्नुभयो अरे भगवानले चाहिँ दुर्गा मातालाई सेवा गर भन्नुभएको छ?
दुर्गा माताले मैले भनेको काम गर भन्नुभएको छ। त्यो काम के हो भनेदेखि तिमीले उहाँ जानु र के अरे यो यो नानीलाई लिएर जानु उहाँ अनि लिएर जानु र अनि कंसलाई चाहिँ कंसले मार नाट्दा तिमी चाहिँ माथि उडेर जानु। त्यसो गरेछौ भने तिम्रो यस पृथ्वी मण्डलमा सबैले पूजा गर्नेछन्, तिमी पूजनीय हुन्छौ भन्नुभएको छ दशम स्कन्दमा। अब हामीले भगवान्ले कृष्णले चाहिँ पूजा गर्छ भनेर भनेका छन् र हामीले पूजा गरिएन भने भगवान्को आज्ञा हामीले नपालेको नपा न यो नेपाली भाषा बोल्न हामीलाई अप्ठ्यारो हुन्छ क्या। पूजालाई आज्ञा पालन नगरेकोमा हामीलाई अपराध लाग्छ कि लाग्दैन?
So Maharaj, Prabhu's question is, in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord Krishna tells to Yoga, to Durga that, you know, deliver, you know, he tells to Durga Mata that you take the, you go to Kamsa's place and, when Kamsa is about to kill you, then you fly off. If you do that, then all the people will be respecting you. And they will worship you in the material world. So, you know, it's his order, kind of like, you know, it's his desire that everyone worships Durga Mata. So if we don't worship Durga in the material world, are we indirectly offending Lord Krishna or not?
Certainly not. There's no offense, because when we worship Lord Krishna, then all the devas are pleased. They're all satisfied.
त्यसमा अपराध लाग्दैन, किनभने हामीले जब भगवान् कृष्णलाई सिधै पूजा गर्छौँ त्यसपछि सबै देवदेवताहरू पनि खुसी हुन्छन्। किनभने प्रमुख अन्तिमको लक्ष्य त सबै देवदेवताहरूले के चाहन्छन् त भन्दाखेरि भगवान्लाई पूजा गर्न चाहन्छन्।
Just like he watered the root of the tulsi tree, all the leaves and branches are nourished.
जस्तै उदाहरणको लागि महाराजले उदाहरण दिनुहुन्छ, जस्तै तुलसीको रुखलाई अथवा कुनै पनि रुखलाई हामीले जरामा पानी हालियो भने पात पतिङ्गरहरूलाई हालिराख्नु पर्दैन।
Lord Krishna is Mula Prakriti. He is the root of the material nature.
Bhagavan Krishna chai mul prakriti hununcha ra wahale hamile jaba seva garincha aru sabai devadevata haru aafai khushi
hunu. So devotee is not, we don't have to worship Mother Durga. We have to by worshipping Krishna, then all the devas, they're all pleased and they're all satisfied and they bestow their blessings on the devotee. Now Srila Vyasadeva, you can read also in Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, Srila Vyasadeva, after instruction from Narada Muni, then he sat in meditation, and then in his meditation he saw Lord Krishna, and he saw the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and he saw the material nature, and it was under the full control of Lord Krishna.
जब श्रीमद् भागवतमको पहिलो स्कन्दमा हामीले देख्न सकिन्छ कि व्यासदेवले लेख्नुहुन्छ कि जब यो भौतिक सृष्टि हुन्छ त्यसपछि सबै कुरा चाहिँ भगवानको नियन्त्रणमा छ भन्ने हामीले देख्न सकिन्छ।
I explained, just like Lord Brahma's prayer, that Mother Durga is like the shadow under the control of the Lord. When the shadow doesn't move independently of the object. So you satisfy Lord Krishna and Mother Durga is satisfied.
Jastai agi Maharaj le Brahma Samhita ko shlok bata bhannu bhayeko thiyo ki jastai Bhagwan hununcha, Bhagwan ko chhaya chai ke ho ta Durga jastai ho. Kunai pani byakti ko euta chhaya chai ke huncha, swatantra hudaina. Chhaya chai byakti anusar chalcha. व्यक्ति अगाडि गयो पछाडि गयो भने छाया पनि त्यही अनुसार चल्छ। त्यस्तै गरेर हामीले भगवान् कृष्णलाई खुसी पार्यौँ भने भगवान्को छाया दुर्गा चाहिँ आफै आफ खुसी हुनुहुन्छ।
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, whatever a man may offer to other gods is actually meant for me alone, but it is offered without proper understanding.
र भगवद् गीतामा भगवान्ले भन्नुभएको छ अरू देवदेवतालाई चढाउने कुराहरू कसैले पूजा गर्छ, केही तर्पण गर्छ भने पनि त्यो खास मलाई नै गरेको,
So the worship of demigods is condemned in the Bhagavad Gita. People whose minds are distorted by material desires worship the demigods to get things which are limited and temporary.
जो व्यक्तिहरु चाहिँ भौतिक इच्छाले एकदम त्रस्त भएका हुन्छन् भौतिक इच्छा प्राप्त गर्नलाई उनीहरूलाई उन्मत्त भएका हुन्छन् त्यस्ता व्यक्तिहरुले मात्रै देवदेवताको पूजा गर्छन् भन्ने
Some people think oh you have to worship Ganesh first before we worship Krishna. That's also wrong, not necessary.
र कोही कोही व्यक्तिहरुले चाहिँ सोच्छन् कि हामीले पहिला गणेशलाई पूजा गर्नुपर्छ भगवान कृष्णको लागि पूजा गर्नुभन्दा अगाडि तर यो पनि खास गर्नुपर्ने छैन
Because Lord Ganesh, he gets the power from the Supreme Lord Govinda. That's also described in Brahma Samhita. Yad pada palavam vinidayakum va danve pranama samaye sakanadi raja vignan vihanta malam asya jagatrayasya govinda madipursam tamaham bhajamin. Lord Krishna, Lord Brahma is saying that the power to destroy the obstacles which we think Ganesh has, he actually gets that power by holding the lotus feet of Govinda on his head.
Brahma Samhita ma Brahma ji le bhanu bhayeko cha yo bhautik jagat ma bhayeka kalmashar lai Ganesh le nash garnuhuncha bhanera bhaniyeko cha kina nash garna saknuhuncha bhanera waha le bhanda kheri kina bhane
So one time one devotee, we were having the temple opening in Hyderabad and we had the temple there. We had deities, we had Gornitai and Radha Madan Mohan and Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. So this one devotee said to Prabhupada, he said, you know Prabhupada, he said, everybody in this city, they all worship Lord Shiva. Maybe we should put a Shiva Linga here. Let everybody come, we'll worship Lord Shiva, and then they can come and... They said, maybe we should put Lord Shiva here and let everybody come. They'll come and worship Shiva, and then they can come and see the deities. And Prabhupada said, no. We're not going to do that. He said, if we do that, they will think everyone's the same. They will think Shiva, Krishna, everyone's it's all one. And Prabhupada did not want that because that's not the philosophy.
अनि गोपीहरुले चाहिँ किन कात्यायनको पूजा गरेर भगवान कृष्णसँग डाइरेक्ट नगरी कात्यायनको पूजाबाट किन यसरी गए भन्ने कुरा जनताले पुछ्छ हामीलाई के उत्तर दिने त्यस्तोमा
ओके So Maharaj, Homnath Prabhu, he's actually sick, that's why he's lying down.
Okay.
I actually requested maybe he should stand up, but he has actually got corona. Tapai lai corona laayo ha Prabhu? Tapai lai corona laayo cha?
Corona laagera ra, aile corona sanja bhayera ma hinna basna sakdina.
So that's why he's affected with corona and he's sick, that's why he's lying down. And his question that he's asking is based on what other people have asked him, because he's also helping preach there. So they ask the second question is, okay, we should not worship the demigod, then why did the gopis also worship like Katyayani to get Krishna?
Yeah, gopis worship Katyayani to get Krishna as a husband. That's right. So you can worship the demigods to get for the pleasure of Krishna. Just like Bharat Maharaj also would make offerings to demigods, but he understood the demigods are part of Krishna. So the gopis, they worship Katyayani. They want Krishna for a husband, because this is for Krishna's pleasure. Krishna wants the gopis for a husband, for their wife, for his wives. So you want to get Krishna for a husband, you can also worship Katyayani.
Maharaj, from what I read, it's also Prabhupada did not want to encourage the demigod to worship because it's very easy to lose the philosophy and, you know, just focus on the demigod worship, right? That's why he...
Yeah, we become Mayavadi. We think they're all one.
Hare
Krishna Guruji.
Hazur.
Tara Krishna book ma 34 va tyo adhyay huncha ni 34 ma tyaneri Prabhupada ji le lekhdinu bhayo cha ki Shiva ji lai Brahma ji lai puja garna sakincha yadi tyo puja garera Krishna ko bhakti prapta huncha bhane bhanera tara ani tya bata Vrindavan ka gwalwale re Shivaratri manako auncha ki tyanera
Shivaratri.
Ah, Shivaratri unharle manako auncha Shivaratri. भगवान स्वयं त्यहाँ प्रकट हुनुहुन्छ र उनीहरूले शिवरात्रि पनि मनाउँछन्।
त्यही अहिले त्यही भन्नुभएको थियो महाराजले, देवदेवताको पूजा गरेर यदि हामीलाई भगवान पाउन छ भन्यो भने त्यसमा चाहिँ ठिकै छ भन्नुभयो। सो महाराज, भीम प्रभु के अरे बृहद भानुप्रभु, त्यहाँ भीम दुलारमा मात्रै लेखेको छ। सो बृहद भानुप्रभु इज सेइङ इन द 34th च्याप्टर अफ कृष्ण बुक, there we can also see the gopis, they are also worshipping Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, but they worship them to get to Krishna or get Krishna's, Lord Krishna's mercy, and they also celebrate Shivaratri. So I think it's also, if we see that in accordance with Lord Vishnu as or Lord Krishna as the supreme, then it's okay, right?
Shivaratri can be observed sometimes, it's not compulsory. But it can be observed, just like in Mayapur, we observe Shivaratri. We have a program at the Jagannath Mandir for Shivaratri. So it can be done.